So Tua yesterday plays well, and everybody's freaking out.
Well, look, I've been somewhat hard on Tua, and wrong, really. Credit Mike McDaniel and those guys. It's one of those teams that's drinking the Kool-Aid and playing well, and they had a good defense a year ago, and so now they have a good offense and an explosive offense, and Tua is following the game plan each week. And so 2 weeks in, certainly I've been wrong, and he's been impressive.
Sean Payton once dissed Tua Tagovailoa pretty hard. Then after the Ravens game last year, he kind of saw the light. Usually I start my Monday reaction video going over the good stuff first and then following up with the bad. But seeing how we saw so much bad from Denver yesterday, I'm going to start off this week's overreaction or instant reaction talking about the Denver Broncos. Because it really was that bad for the Denver Broncos. Yesterday, that light that shone on Sean Payton was the bright South Florida sunshine, and it exposed Sean Payton and the Denver Broncos really bad. And Sean Payton wasn't feeling it at all.
This was bad.
That was embarrassing and tough to watch. Well, look, you know, it'd be one thing to say, hey, we're going to get on to the next game, but we have to watch that tape. You know, and so tomorrow will be, you know, be tough for a lot of players. Tough for us, too, as coaches.
You said it's embarrassing, but this is kind of an historic game. I mean, it's
I'm aware.
Third time the team has scored 70 points over 70.
What's the question? What's the question?
How do you feel about it being
I just finished telling you.
Historically embarrassing.
Next question. I mean, I'm at a loss for words because I've never been in. I've been on the other side of some games like that. And then every once in a while in this league, you get your butt whipped, but this was more than that.
Sean Payton wants to go back and look at film. Don't do that. Here's a hint for Coach Payton. Don't watch the film. It's a horror film with a really bloody, gory ending. You don't want to see that. It will give you nightmares. Here's what you need to do. Fire your defensive coordinator and cut a bunch of players and look for some free agents.
Come in here quick, because damn.
This was really bad.
It was so bad that former Denver Broncos Hall of Famer Shannon Sharp says it's an organizational problem that they're going to have to deal with.
Here's the thing, Ocho, when you get 70 hung on you, that's yes, telling you your entire organization from top to bottom isn't good enough. The person that picks the talent, the people that coach the talent itself isn't good enough.
What do the Broncos do from here?
Well, they don't have any choice. This is the roster that you have. This is the coaches. Mm-hmm. This is the team that you have. The Penner and the Walton family has spent an enormous sum of money. Money is not the issue. They purchased this team 2 years ago, and they gave Russell Wilson money when they didn't have to. They gave Sean Payton $18 to $20 million to turn this thing around. Well, damn it, turn it around. Now, it's going to take some time because this tells me the talent that they have is not good enough, Ocho. You don't give up 70 points in an NFL game. 70 points is the most points since 1966. I was born in 68. I'm 55.
Yeah.
You weren't even thought of in 66. You were born in 78. You were born in 78. As a matter of fact,
I was born in 68, man, at Jackson Memorial Hospital at 308.
Well, you can say whatever you want to say. First of all, we both know you weren't born in 68. So think about that. So that's what it tells me.
Right.
And see, me, I would have kicked the field goal because I do you a favor. See, when I beat you by a lot of points, Ocho, I tell you, your players aren't good enough. Your staff isn't good enough. See, if I kick a walk-off field goal, you actually think you had a chance. If I beat you by a touchdown, you say, I got a chance. When I drop a 70 piece on you, that lets you know. Now ownership is looking at everything from top to bottom.
Top to bottom.
They getting coached properly? Are they getting trained properly? Are they eating properly? Do we have the right personnel to do what's being asked of them? There's a lot more questions than answers.
Now that we have that nightmarish stuff out of the way, let's recognize some of the Miami Dolphins.
The good stuff.
There was so much good stuff, I don't know where to begin. But let's jump right into it. While the Dolphins didn't set the NFL scoring record, there was so much awesomeness, they didn't really need to. They were the first team to score 70 points with 700 yards of offense. They were the first team to score 5 rushing touchdowns and 5 passing touchdowns in the same game. Even Mike White got into it. They were the first team to have two players score 4 touchdowns each, Raheem Mostert and Devon Achane. Tua Tagovailoa chipped in, obviously, with 309 yards passing and 4 touchdowns, and the offensive line didn't let him get touched. Not a single sack all game. The Miami Dolphins had no turnovers, no fumbles, no interceptions, no bobbled snaps. And I gotta give a hat tip to Jason Sanders. Jason Sanders made 10 straight extra points. That's pretty awesome.
This was the best.
How do you give out a best of reward when there's so much bestiness going on? But today, let's give the Rook a nod. Rookie Devon Achane was the best. In what was an obvious breakout game, Devon Achane carried the ball 18 times for 203 yards and 2 touchdowns. That came out to an amazing, a whopping, and oh my God, 11.3 yards per carry.
21 gigawatts!
But wait, I'm not done. It gets better. He caught 2 touchdowns on 2 amazing inside shovel passes from Tua Tagovailoa. Mike McDaniel decides to put a play in just for Devon Achane, and Tua executes a no-look shovel pass for a touchdown and then did it again later in the game. I think the second one he actually looked. Maybe he should have looked away just to rub it in a little bit more, but the first one was a complete no-look shovel pass. In any event, you got to give it to the rookie today. Simply an amazing performance.
Grading the coach.
All right, let's talk about the coaches. So today, I'm going to give Vic Fangio a B. Only reason it's a B, because I can't imagine how hard it is to motivate a team of players when you're already stomping the hell out of your opponent and you're up by 30, 40, 50 points. Nonetheless, the defense held the Broncos' running game in check. They got a sack, they got an interception, and they forced 2 fumbles. Next week, you face the Buffalo Bills, which will be your biggest test to date. Get ready. As for Mike McDaniel, simply an A+. Doesn't get any better than that. A+. You are a passing game genius. Yesterday, you showed us you can be a running game genius. And that new shovel pass, that is pure genius. And as for the NFL scoring record, although some fans were upset, getting greedy, you handled that with pure class.
I try to think through all of my decisions and hold them with the importance that they do have. It felt like chasing points and chasing a record. That's not what we came to the game to do. That doesn't have a bearing on the overall season outcome. And I just didn't. I saw it as. In that 10 times out of 10, you concede and kneel down in those situations because there was a attainable record. That was cool, but the message that I thought it would send wasn't really in line with how I view things. It's awesome to. I think it was the most points since 66 or something. I think that's awesome for a regular season record. You can have that and then suffer the same fate as we had last year. I don't care about that regular season record. It would have been cool, but what we're trying to do. I think that would be talking out of both sides of my mouth if we went and tried to send the field goal team on and squeeze an extra 3. It's not really what I'm about. I will be fine getting second guessed by turning down NFL records. That's fine. I'm very, very okay with the decision. And I think the team, notably the leaders of the team, supported it. The captains supported it. It's not the way you want to get the record. I would hope that if the shoe was on the other foot, the opponent would feel the same way. And that's called karma. And I'm trying to keep good karma with the Miami Dolphins.
Right now, Miami Dolphins fans, enjoy it. Mike McDaniel is on his way to NFL Coach of the Year, no doubt.
My offensive player of the game.
For the reasons stated earlier, Devon Achane is my offensive player of the game. But Tua Tagovailoa is a close second. I mean, really close second. It could have almost been co-offensive players of the game. But it's the rookie's first shot, and so I got to give it to him. Now I got to give a full disclosure. He embarrassed me. When I watched the NFL draft in April and I saw that the Miami Dolphins picked some guy named Devon Achane in the third round, I had it. I lost it. I said this was a wasted draft pick. Chris Greer didn't know what the hell he was doing. Why would you spend a third round draft pick on a diminutive little running back out of Texas A&M? I said Chris Greer was out of his mind. And damn, I was wrong. Yes. I said it, I was wrong. Devon Achane has superstar written all over him. All over him. What a fantastic find by Chris Greer and the organization. So much so, can we never bring up the words Dalvin Cook or Jonathan Taylor ever again? Even next year, if Jonathan Taylor is a free agent, don't even think about it. Don't even look towards Indianapolis. You got a stud. For sure, Devon Achane is a stud. And yes, I've booked my ticket on the A-Chain Express. I was dead wrong. This kid is a superstar in the making.
My defensive player of the game.
What do you say? Javon Holland seems to be getting better every single week. And oh my God, he's got Thor's hammer. He has one of the best punches I've ever seen in football. He took points away from the Denver Broncos with those punch outs. In addition, he had 8 tackles. Great game by Javon Holland in a blowout. I know it's very hard to keep the defense motivated when you're up by 30, 40, 50 points, but they played hard, and Javon Holland is my defensive player of the game. So there's my reaction to yesterday's game. Now we're off to the Buffalo Bills. Let me know, was that a good reaction or an overreaction on Monday? And don't forget, join me tomorrow. Tua Tuesday. Click the link here to get notified. The original Tua Tuesday. The Tua Tuesday that's been going on for over a year. Not some mimic, not some copycat. The original Tua Tuesday tomorrow at 7 p.m. Just click the link here to be notified when I go live. Talk to you soon. Fins up.
Is anybody catching on to this Barry guy?